Well, good evening and welcome to our community update and prayer. This is Bishop Desmond from Vision Temple of Praise. And God bless you this evening. Been a busy evening for me. I've just come off a Black History Month webinar with a group from Nottingham. And as many of you know, I am not a major fan of Black History Month because I believe that we are God's children and our history is every single day of the week. And you know, we must never let our souls be cocooned into what anybody says where we should be, because we all know where we need to be, which is something very, very different. And God places us, because in Corinthians, we're reminded in 1 Corinthians 12:12-27, I won't be reading all of it, but it says, "For as the body is one and has many members, but all members of that one body, being many, are one body. So also is Christ. For by one Spirit we were baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, whether slaves or free, and have all been made to drink into one Spirit. For in fact, the body is not one member, but many." And do you know, sometimes that's been lost, because what we have is, we have many people thinking, "I am greater than you." But clearly, this scripture is reminding us about our unity and our diversity. There's two buzzwords for you. Unity. We all should be a part of one. We are a part of the family of God. But importantly as well, we all come in various shapes and sizes, different skin colors, etc. But it's what's on the inside that matters more than anything else. And how many of us really focus upon that? And I want to focus upon that later on. But we're going to give you some community matters, some updates. The We Matter Party, many of you know I'm leader of the We Matter Party. Unfortunately, our public meeting tomorrow evening at Panelcroft Village has been postponed because of circumstances beyond our control. So we're looking at having our meeting in November, but tomorrow night, Panelcroft Village, that's been cancelled, I'm afraid. So please, anyone thinking of coming along to that, please just drop us an email at wematterparty@gmail.com. Go to our website, send a message through, we'll get back in touch with you. But very sorry, that meeting's now been postponed. And moving on, thank you for those who turned up. And we had a wonderful service on Sunday at Vision Temple of Praise. As you know, we do meet every Sunday at Panelcroft Village, and we meet again this Sunday. And this will be the final part of our five-part sermon on transformation. Because, you know, there are times when we like to conform to the norm. We don't want to upset anybody. We want everything to be on the same page. But unfortunately, there are times when we have to transform, because guess what? Sometimes you have to turn the page, don't you? But how many of us want to turn the page? Sometimes we've got to leave our comfort zone in order for greater progression. And I'm sure you'll agree with that. Well, I hope you do, in any case. So, So this Sunday at Panelcroft Village. Also, as well, some other community dates for you as well. South Aston Matters Community Forum will meet next Wednesday, and that will be at 7 o'clock, and that will be at the South Aston United Reformed Church in Upper Sutton Street, Aston. Do come along to that. We're inviting the police, the fire service, the local authority, the housing department, also alongside the local councillors as well. So do join us. That's 7 o'clock, 7 p.m. until 8 p.m. and that's next Wednesday at South Aston United Reformed Church in Upper Sutton Street, Aston. And these community forums are doing quite well. We started off with one and now there are five, and with another two to come on board in North Aston and also the Aston Manor area of Newtown as well. So as I've said, that's next Wednesday, which is the 3rd of November. Also as well, the Central Newtown Community Forum, which is the area of Newtown where Aldi is and Panelcroft Village, where the tower blocks are, etc. So Porchester Drive, Guildford Drive, Attenborough Close, Summer Lane, just to give you an idea of some of the names. Monday, 8th of November 2021, 6:30 till 7:30 p.m. And that meeting will be at Panelcroft Village in the main hall there. So that's Monday, 8th November 2021. And after that, no December meeting, and the meeting after that will be in January. Now, a Windrush meeting will be taking, a Windrush public meeting, public engagement meeting will be taking place, and members of our Windrush National Organisation team will be there. And this will be taking place on Tuesday, the 9th of November, 2021. So that's next week, a week on Tuesday coming. And it's 6:30 p.m. until 8:30 p.m. And the venue for that is the Church of God of Prophecy, 196 Chapel Town Road in Leeds, LS7 4HZ. 6:30 until 8:30, and there'll be a Windrush meeting there in Leeds. Speakers include myself, we'll have Reverend Clive Foster, and we'll also have Nigel, Reverend Clive Foster from Nottingham, he'll be going, and also we've got Nigel Guyford, all from the Windrush National Organisation, and we'll be joining an organisation called CAHLP in Leeds to look at assisting people caught up in the Windrush scandal. Please spread the word. We will have a representative from the Home Office Status team there to talk to people individually, and please express to people that, you know, they're not going to be detained or anything like that. So clearly, do come to that if you've been impacted by the Windrush scandal. Got to be careful how I put this at the moment, because as we know, with immigration, other things are happening at the moment with people being detained in terms of potentially another mass deportation flight. But there are two sets of circumstances here at play. Although some will say, well, it's all interconnected. But right now, those who have been here for 40, 50 years, you know, those who were here before 1988, you haven't got a British passport, or you've been impacted by the Windrush scandal and you live in Leeds, please come to this meeting, or spread the word to come to this meeting on Tuesday, 9th November at 6:30 p.m. at the Church of God of Prophecy, Chapel Town in Leeds. Also as well, just to add to that, Lazelle's Community Forum in November, the last meeting for the year, will be on Monday, 15th November 2021 at 6:30 p.m. And at the moment, the venues is St. Paul's and St. Silas Church in Lazelle's. And Burberry Park Community Forum, their last meeting for the year will be Monday, 22nd November 2021. And that'll be at 7:30 p.m. at the Burberry Park Centre as well. So please note those dates. Also as well, a pop-up police station initiative that we got going in Lazelle's, running quite successfully. And that's at the St. Paul's and St. Silas Church every Tuesday between 1 p.m. and 3 p.m. And this is about accessibility to the police. So it's not a call centre. It's, you will be speaking to police officers or PCSOs when you attend there. We've listened, many people have said, we can't see a police officer, we don't know where to go. Well, every Tuesday in Lazelle's, you can go between 1 and 3 and you will be able to see a police officer. Importantly now, this initiative may well be adopted in other areas as well. So let's have a look at it. But, you know, you've got any issues, and that includes even if you want to go in and complain about the service you're getting from the police, please feel free to go in there, because, you know, everyone's welcomed. And, you know, it is a welcoming environment. I do pop in occasionally to have a look, and it is a welcoming environment. So do go in, do find out what's happening. And importantly as well, you know, have your say. That's what I always say. Have your say, because that's important. Now, COVID-19 update. There's a lot of things going on right now with COVID. Sadly, we're getting more deaths with COVID. I've just come off the phone to someone who's gasping to breathe right now, and they're waiting for an ambulance. And one of the things being highlighted as well at the moment are ambulance response times. And it is now of concern. Clearly, our NHS people are doing a grand job, but something's not going according to plan. And we've had reports of people waiting up to 5 hours for an ambulance because the ambulance services are busy. Unfortunately, we are seeing some of our people in our community. And when I say our community, I mean our community where we live, all over the city, are dying. And clearly, there's something that needs to be done. And the update from Birmingham Public Health, Healthy Brom, it says a Halloween reminder that COVID is not a trick and catching it is no treat, so please continue to protect yourself. Well, first of all, I'm not a great believer in Halloween anyway, but I will agree COVID is not a trick because we're seeing too many people in our communities dying. Now, this week, cases across Birmingham has actually decreased compared to last week, but the decrease is decreased by about 170 people. So new cases this week are 3,213 compared to 3,380 last week. So it's a decrease of approximately 5%. The 10 wards with the highest rates per 100,000 population. Sutton is still quite up there, actually. So Sutton Rugeley is 604, Sutton Trinity 594, then Shard End 593. But then we go back to Sutton Four Oaks 535, down to Druids Heath 519. Then we go back to Sutton Mere Green 507, Kings Norton South 504, then back to Sutton again 499, and then King Standing 447, and Sutton Redicap 430. Bottom line is North Birmingham particularly is an area of concern. New cases are down, as we've said. The rate of cases per 100,000 has slightly reduced as well. Then the rate of testing has reduced as well. So that's that has actually, the rate of testing has gone down. And this week as well, the rate of PCR and lateral flow tests as well have actually decreased slightly. However, let's not be complacent about this, because there is clearly talk of potentially the government putting in a plan B. I personally believe that we're not going to be very far away from a lockdown. It may well be the case that, you know, there could be a lockdown after Christmas if things last that long, in all honesty. But we'll have to see, because the problem is the rates are increasing and vaccination rates are still not being picked up in many parts of the inner city areas of Birmingham. However, this is the big however that I have to say to you is this. We will be seeking to try and have surgeries to discuss the fears that people have in terms of the vaccine. A lot of messages have been going around and they've been sending around negative messages clearly regarding the whole issue of COVID. But we're seeing too many people in our communities dying. So I think we need to set up the opportunity for people to come and have open and frank discussion regarding what fears they may have, so that those fears are, at least then you're making an informed decision. And I think that's the thing, because it's important to make informed decisions more than anything else. Today was the budget. Today the budget was delivered, or the autumn statement, by the Chancellor, Richie Sunak. And there were various issues here. And there's good news for drinkers, but there's bad news for long-haul travellers and tough announcements for pensioners as well, it's been reported. The annual subscription limit for individual saving accounts will be maintained at 20,000. But there were no mention of regular savers Pensioners left with the annual income lifetime pension allowances untouched. The allowance has been dramatically cut over the past decade and is now frozen at £1,073,100 until 2026. Long haul travellers will have an ultra long haul band in air passenger duty covering flights of over 5,500 miles with an economy rate of £91. Less than 5% passengers will pay more, but those who fly the furthest will pay the most. So at the moment, I expect those travelling to the Caribbean, for example, you're within that 5,500 miles, but it doesn't say if it's a round trip or not. That's the thing about it. So I don't know if they're going to place a tax on the overall journey, for which then that tax rate will take a bit of a hike. National insurance has been put up, as we know, but it's formally announced at 1.25% national insurance. And for you smokers out there, the price of a 20-pack of cigarettes will soar by 88 pence, with the extra levy coming into effect. Well, it's in effect now. Came into effect at 6 o'clock. Just give up smoking. That's nearly a pound, folks. Come on. But then again, you're going to say to me, well, that's where I get comfort from, a cigarette. Join us in church on a Sunday. Let's pray together. Let's get some comfort through prayer. Some are going to disagree with me. But at the end of the day, 88 pence on a pack of 20 cigarettes, which is now in place. You know, you'll soon need a mortgage to buy a pack of cigarettes. The planned rise in fuel duty has now been cancelled. Pump prices are at their highest level in 8 years, and that's true. It's about £1.40 a litre for petrol at the moment. And diesel, they're all in the £1.40s as well. And I think, you know, they went up as well overall during the mini fuel crisis as well. Alcohol is being radically simplified, introducing a system designed around a principle of the stronger the drink, the higher the rate. Therefore, and there's a draft release as well. They're cutting tax by 5% for draft containers over 14 litres and bringing the price of a pint down by 3 pence. But please remember, don't drink and drive. Okay. Universal credit will increase to £9. The minimum wage for universal credit will increase to £9.50 an hour next year, up from £8.91. And low-paid workers' minimum wage will increase to £9.50 an hour next year from £8.91 as well. In the hospitality sector, a new 50% business rates discount will apply in the retail, hospitality and leisure sectors, with eligible businesses being able to claim a discount off their bills up to a maximum of £110,000. And short-haul holiday makers, flights between airports in England, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland will be subject to a new lower rate of air passenger duty from April 2023. And gov.uk is where you can see everything there. So I suggest that you just go to government's website, gov.uk, and you will be able to pick up on the budget there. And the announcements made by Richie Sunak, the Chancellor of the Exchequer. So very much a whole host of information there and a lot of things that are going on in our city. Also as well today, Birmingham City Council's Housing Department, and many of you may or may not be aware that I've been assisting a gentleman by the name of Ezekiel Herman, who is left in a tower block on his own in Druids Heath. Many people are critical of this man, but today we got some news here. Today, Birmingham City Council was deemed, their actions deemed to be unlawful when dealing with people who are homeless or potentially homeless, particularly people with disabilities. High Court judges have said that Birmingham City Council was operating an unlawful system for providing temporary accommodation. Families in need of temporary housing, it said, were left in unsuitable homes whilst the council sought properties. Court heard families were left in the inappropriate accommodation for considerable amounts of times. A claimant who is disabled with multiple serious health conditions and requires a power wheelchair and has a two-bedroom bungalow since 2018, it was deemed the property needed adaptations to meet her needs, and the council initially instructed contractors to make them, but later withdrew the plans as it was temporary accommodation. But I know for a fact that a single man in good health has been offered a bungalow with adaptations in. Bit of confusion there by Birmingham Housing Department, would you not say? Claimant B and his wife share their two-bedroom housing association house with their six children, one of whom is severely disabled. They applied to the council for suitable accommodation in 2018, but they have remained in the property while an alternative was sought. In 2020, claimant B was offered a second floor flat. Well, you got six children, second floor flat anyway, which he refused due to access problems for a disabled child and was subsequently removed from the housing register in January. Now, Birmingham City Council, what is going on? The Community Law Partnership, which represented the claimant, said these family and many others are in a similar position, have suffered as a result of the unlawful practice of the council, the effect of which is that many homeless applicants are left in unsuitable accommodation, sometimes in appalling conditions for considerable periods of time, despite an acknowledgement on the part of the council they are owed the main housing duty under the homeless legislation. A council spokesperson said it was disappointed with the ruling on what is considered to be its lawful and consistent approach. Well, clearly your consistent approach is not working, and it has been deemed today to be unlawful. There is a chronic housing shortage nationally. As with most of other local authorities, there is an extreme difficulty in sourcing accommodation, exacerbated further by, yes, here we go, the COVID-19 pandemic, rendering properties in even shorter supply than normally would be the case. Well, how about the fact that the housing strategy of demolition in Birmingham, which has drastically reduced 110,000 properties down to 70,000, not all on the right to buy legislation, demolishing tower blocks that the city has failed to maintain, and not replacing the properties at all. We're still seeing properties after nearly 15 years being built on the old Birchfield estate, 500 properties replaced with about 80, a tower block in Aston, 119 properties being replaced with 8. We've said there's another one being built at the moment. Yes, it is happening. You know, another 119 properties being replaced with about 30. It's nice to have new properties, folks. But when you're going to say you've got a chronic housing shortage, you've got it because of the policies that you've adopted and also a failure to maintain. Oh, by the way, as many know, I used to work for the housing department over 20 years ago. So I have got a little tiny bit of a clue what I'm talking about. So, you know, look, folks, it's not good. And I think it's going to get far worse before it gets better. But let us hang in there. Let us do what we can. But clearly, our council has a lot to answer for. And importantly as well, our councillors, what are you doing? What are you doing? Some updates. The application made by KJANS for a supportive living project for women in Lascelles, despite objections being led by the local councillor, has been approved, that planning application, because there were no foundation in law for the objections that were put in. Importantly as well, we're still waiting to hear about the plans for the observatory, or the former observatory on the junction of Barker Street and Hunters Road. They appealed that decision not to grant them a liquor license for the restaurant. The Lascelles Community Forum meeting, the person who was applying for that license did attend, and no objections were raised there by the people who attended that public meeting on Monday. last Monday. So just to let you know, we're doing things, we're getting on with it. There's still a long way to go. It's still a long journey as well. But remember, the final announcement today, Wendy Williams, who wrote the Windrush Lessons Learnt review, Wendy Williams has now called for evidence about how the Home Office is dealing with people who have been caught up in the Windrush scandal. And all you need to do is to, if you go to Google and Google Wendy Williams review, then you that will take you in. That will take you into where you need to go. So, and that will take you in so that you can actually give your evidence. So please get involved, have your say. It's your opportunity to do so. So on that note, we will see you on Sunday at our service, Vision Temple of Praise, Panelcroft Village. Someone asked me, is it just for the residents or can anyone attend? It's an open service. We hire the hall. You are more than welcome to come in, join us and share fellowship with one another. So let's make it happen. Let's do that. And just going back to our scripture tonight, if the foot should say, because I am not a hand, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body? If an ear should say, because I am not the eye, I am not a part of the body. Listen, our bodies are made up of all components and we're all equally as important as the other. So let no one tell you otherwise. But importantly, we need to be working in unity. That's the key element that I wanted to get across to you tonight. So until next week, God bless you. Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us together today. Father God, we thank you, we praise and adore your name. Father, we just pray for those who are sick tonight, Father. Father, we pray for those who are tending to those who are sick. Father, we focus upon those who are sick tonight. But Father God, we focus upon the grieving families, Father. Some of them who are mourning as well. Father, we just ask that you bless us now, we pray. Give us that continuous guidance, we pray, Father God. We ask you to continue to bless each and every one of us. Let us do what is right in your sight. Let us not skirm away from our responsibilities. Let us stand by the truth. Let us do what is right at all times, we pray, Father God. Let no weapon formed against your people prosper. Father, we pray for priests in our streets right now. We've lost so many of our youngsters, Father. So many men, so many women, Father. There are so many trials in the courts right now, Father, for crimes which have been committed. But we ask you right now, in the name of Jesus, to bless in each and every one. Bless those who are working in our community to make things better. Father, guide and protect your people. Keep us going, we pray. And Father, just let us do what is right in your sight. And let us continue to do so. We ask for your guidance. We ask for your blessings right now, we pray. Just keep us going. And let us do what is right by your sight. Bless us now, we pray. Keep us safe. And as we pray for those who are sick, and we've had the calls, Father, of those who are waiting ambulances. Father God, bless us, we pray. Protect us, we pray. Keep us going as we give you thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. As we say, amen. So until we meet again, God bless you. Have a wonderful rest of the week.